In this video, we'll discuss the Saved Plan Views feature in Chief Architect. The goal of this feature is to make it easier to work on different tasks without having to constantly change the current plan view settings. In previous versions, we could only work on a single plan view at a time. If you wanted to work on a different area of the model, you would have to change the number of current view settings. For example, you may have had to change floors, switch to a different layer set, change the annotation set, or modify the reference display. This feature makes it possible to save plan views along with all of those associated settings so that they can be reopened in the same state. You can have as many of these views open as you want and just switch between the views to work on them. When you open a new plan with the out-of-the-box default template, there are several saved plan views already integrated into the plan, and you can see these plan views in the project browser. I can choose the project browser button here, or we could go into the View menu and choose Project Browser from here. In the Project Browser, there is a folder for plan views, and if I expand this folder, you can see that we have the working plan view. This is the plan view that we recommend using to do all the preliminary design work. And below this, we have a variety of task-oriented plan views that you can use to organize your drawing. Let's open a plan file that already has a drawing started. In the project browser, you can see both plans, the Untitled plan and the Saved Plan Views plan. I'm going to go ahead and close out of the Untitled plan. In the Saved Plan Views plan, I'll expand the Plan Views folder. You can see the word Open next to the working plan view. If we switch our current plan view using the Saved Plan View control here, you'll see that the Open indicator changed to the plan view that is currently in use. If we double-click on one of these saved views in the project browser, you'll see that we now have two views open. You can see the additional tab on the top of the drawing space. It is still only one plan, but we have two views of this plan open. We can examine each saved plan view in the project browser to see exactly what it is saving. If I right-click on this and choose Open Object, we'll see the saved plan view specification. In here, we can see that it is saving what floor we're on. In this case, it's using any floor. The zoom and rotation, whether or not it has color or a watermark turned on. It is using the electrical annotations, because we opened up the electrical plan view, as well as the electrical layer set. You can see which defaults are active in that electrical annotation set, and we can see that we do not have a reference floor turned on. I'll go ahead and close out of this, and if I open up another one, we can see that in this plan view, we're using the quarter-inch scale annotations and the floor plan dimensioned layer set. So as we're switching between our saved plan views, it is switching our layer set and our annotation set for us. I'll close out of this dialog. Now, as you're changing your floor plan view using the floor plan view control here, also notice that we have a couple of other drop-down menus that will change with it. So this is your layer set, and this is your active dimension defaults. So as we're changing our plan view, those defaults and layer sets are changing with us. Let's dig into this process. I'll close out of this version of the plan, and I'm going to open up a version that has fewer annotations. I've deleted the dimensions and such out of this plan. All right, so right now we are in the working plan view. As mentioned before, you can do the majority of work in this view. When we work with dimensions, it is best if we pay attention to what dimension default we're using, and we could use the dimension defaults control here. It is also useful to pay attention to our layer set as well, which is up here. Because a plan can get very busy, if we're drawing dimensions on top of dimensions, if we use the Save Plan View control, we can switch both of these at the same time, as well as the other settings that we discussed in that specification. We could switch to the Floor Plan View, Dimensioned, Saved Plan View. Notice that we do not have dimensions in here yet. Note that the quarter-inch scale dimension defaults is what is chosen here, as well as the Floor Plan Dimensioned layer set. We can put in some dimensions. I'll click and drag right here. If I select this dimension and open it up, we can see that this is using the quarter-inch scale dimension defaults, which is what I would expect. And if we go over to the layer, it's on the dimensions manual layer. I'll go ahead and click OK on that. And let's switch to the electrical plan view. You can see that that dimension is no longer there because that manual dimensions layer is turned off in this view. If I grab my manual dimension tool and I click and drag another dimension, I can select this dimension and open it up, and we can see that it is using the electrical dimension defaults. And if I go over to layer, we can see that it's on the electrical dimensions layer. I'll switch over to our framing view. I don't see any framing because I have not yet generated it in this version of the plan. So let's go ahead and build our floor joists for floor 2. I'll go to build and then go to framing, and then we'll choose build framing. This is the subfloor for floor 1. I want to build what's up on floor 2, so we'll go up, and now we have subfloor for floor 2. I'll build my floor framing and I'll click OK. So here's our floor joists for floor 2. I'll switch over to the kitchen and bath saved plan view now. Notice that it zoomed in, and this is because I have set this plan view to be at this zoom level and what floor it's on. So if I expand this plan views folder again and I right click on this kitchen and bath, I'll open object, and you can see that we are remembering our zoom and rotation. And I'll go ahead and change this to remember that this is going to be on the first floor. And this way, if I go up to the second floor and I come back to this kitchen and bath plan view, it'll take me back down to the first floor. So I'll go ahead and click OK. I'll go ahead and switch views. We'll go back to that framing view. Zoom out. If I go back to the kitchen and bath view, it'll zoom me right back in where I was. Now, I do want to use the same layer set and annotation set for the bath views for this plan. So I'd like to make a copy of this view by right-clicking on this kitchen and bath plan view in our project browser, and I'm going to choose copy. We're going to call this just the bath plan view first floor, because I have a bath on the first floor and I have a bath on the second floor. So if I switch to this bath view, which is where I'm currently at, I could zoom in on this view. If I right click and open object, yes, we'll go ahead and save it. And we're going to choose, we're on the first floor, remember zoom rotations, kitchen and bath layer set, NKBA annotations. We have all the NKBA defaults set, so I'll go ahead and click OK. So now this bath plan view is saved, and this kitchen plan view is saved. I'll close out of this view. If I switch to that bath view, it'll pop us right over. If I switch back to the kitchen and bath view, it'll take us back. So I can go up to the second floor, and perhaps I want to zoom in on this bathroom. And we're going to make a copy of this. This will be our second floor. I'll click OK. And now we're going to switch back up to our second floor, zoom back in on this bathroom, and we'll make sure that we're using this bath plan view second floor, and we'll save our plan view using this tool button here. We could also save the plan view by opening up that specification again and clicking OK. One of the strengths of this feature is the fact that you can have multiple plan views open at a time. So I'll go ahead and close out of the kitchen and bath view. And let's go ahead and open up that framing. I'll go up, and there's my floor framing. I can grab this tab and pull it over, and now we can see our floor joists as well as our bathroom. Now in our framing plan here, we can open this up and we can use a reference floor referring to the second floor using the reference display set, and I'll click OK. So now we can see where our fixtures are to make sure that our framing doesn't interfere with our fixture placement or vice versa. And if necessary, we could grab the fixtures in this view and see how they're lining up with our framing view. If you have multiple options for a room in the same plan, you can use the Saved Zoom Factor option to zoom in on option A, and then a different saved view could be set up for option B. I don't recommend having multiple full plans in a single plan file, as it can get rather complex, but for individual rooms it's okay. So Saved Plan Views is a tool that you can use to quickly switch between different layer sets, annotation sets, active defaults, zoom level, floor level, and reference floor. We can use it to reference multiple sections of the plan file at the same time, or create different options for a remodel project.